the Mobula HD. So I've had this thing for a while. I just haven't had time to make a video about it. I did want to make a video about it because I do think it's a really interesting quad. It is another quad in this Cinewhoop category, which all of them kind of suffer from the same issues, which is they usually weigh a little bit too much for the prop size that they have on board. And what that results in is your throttle feeling like an on-off switch or being really inconsistent and difficult to modulate. So you'll reach a point in the throttle where the quad just kind of takes off and you just shoots up, or you're too low below that point and it starts dropping like a rock. And unfortunately, that point is somewhat inconsistent. You can't just, you know, nail it and maintain your altitude really nicely and cleanly. This quad in particular does perform pretty good. And I'll compare it to something like the iFlight Cinebee, which is this thing over here, if you don't remember. I'm now taking it apart and it's totally apart. What was really great about this quad is that it had really great attitude hold. So what I mean by that is that when you are cruising forward and you're just sliding along and just slowly moving about, the attitude is really, really locked in. And if you're not like dealing with prop wash, the whole attitude of the quad is really solid. It really feels solid. Unfortunately, as I said, the throttle is really inconsistent and difficult to modulate. Now, this one is not very different. The throttle still is inconsistent and difficult to manage. However, what is different about it is that it weighs a whole lot less than the iFlight Cinebee, and that results in far better flight performance. This thing is 75 grams with the 3S 300 milliamp battery on board, which is really amazing because that's the weight that I'm running my toothpick frames on 2S. And at that weight with a 2.5 inch prop, it performs really stellar. Unfortunately, this does not have a 2.5 inch prop. It has a much smaller prop, so it does not perform the same. Still, throttle is inconsistent. Your stick inputs and roll pitch are also relatively inconsistent because of the weight as well as the prop guards, which just restrict airflow and make it not perform the way you want. Now, I'm talking about performance and acrobatic flying, where this is not necessarily intended for such things. It's really intended to just cruise about in Cinewhoop style. In my opinion, that's just somewhat boring to me, and I don't have a lot of subject content to get really slow footage of. Maybe you do, and maybe this is a category that you're particularly interested in. I am interested in it because I do want to fly fun acro with something that has an HD camera on board. Unfortunately, all the split cameras that I've tried so far struggle with giving you the appropriate vertical field of view in order to properly fly and maintain whatever attitude you want in the air and do the moves that you want while still being able to see where you're going. And this is no different. This is using the Caddx Turtle or Turtlet camera, and it has a very shallow vertical field of view, so it does struggle to allow you to fly true acro in true acro style. However, the quad does perform pretty well. On 3S with 75 grams all up weight, it does perform really great, and you also get 3 to 4 minutes of just cruising time, which is pretty stellar for something of this size with an HD camera on board. It really does perform great. One thing I would say about the Turtle camera is that the way it comes, you actually have to push the darn button to get it to start recording, then you have to push it again to stop recording. Other people have told me that there is a way to switch it to the mode where it just starts recording when you plug the battery in, and then it stops recording and saves when you unplug the battery. I haven't figured that out yet. The rest of the quad is using the VTX from the trash can, so that's a 200 milliwatt VTX. Underneath, you'll see a CrazyBee F4 V2 board, not a V2.1 board. And this is the primary flaw with this quad. Piroflip has sold hundreds of these things, and there is a stack of about 100 in the corner of the shop that Happy Model is not supporting, which is weird. And they have all burnt out, because the boards just don't hold up, and it's really unfortunate. This board just does not hold up lately. It used to hold up in the, you know, earlier batches, but it doesn't hold up lately with 2S or 3S. With 1S, it holds up great. I mean, it's really hard to burn something when you're not even running above 5 volts of voltage in the thing. So because of this one annoying flaw, I really can't recommend this quad because it's not cheap. And if it burns out, you do have to kind of rebuild the whole thing. You might as well just wait for somebody to make a board that doesn't burn out. Other things I would talk about is that the props are pretty much standard Whoop props. The motors are the 1102 Happy Model motors, and they are actually pretty good. I'm actually impressed with these motors. They do have bearings. They are pretty smooth. The magnets aren't the strongest, but they're also not the weakest. They're pretty good performers. I think this motor size is very suitable for Whoops of this size. And if it didn't have the HD camera on board and it did drop a little bit of weight, I think this would perform really well. If they remade the trash can with this general frame design and with these motors and a new 2.1 board that doesn't burn out, which is now basically an entirely new quad, it would be a really good quad. Unfortunately, the trash can has really awful motors. It just doesn't perform very well. There's another quad I'm going to talk about in a future video, probably two videos from now. It's the UR-UAV UR85. And this is pretty much identical to the Mobula HD, except that it's got larger props. And I'll talk about that moving forward. I just wanted to share this because I have had it for a while. I do think it's a cool quad. It does perform really great. It's not something that I really care to fly. It's really unfortunate that the throttle control is wonky and doesn't really give you great throttle control. And the boards do burn out. However, there's other things that are good about it, and it does give us something to look forward to in the future because it means that we're probably going to get things that perform better. Anyways, thanks for watching. Don't forget to floss your teeth because your teeth are important, unlike these boards for Happy Model to support.